Hey everyone, it's Britta Riches from RunPerfect.com. Today I'm going to talk to you about why running with a midfoot strike landing pattern, which means running with your forefoot in your heel, striking the ground all at the same time, why and how landing with a midfoot strike landing pattern may be the nut to many of your injurious problems that may be preventing you from advancing your overall running progress in terms of preventing injuries. The main problem with running with a midfoot strike landing pattern is that running in this way may create the same impact platform or the high impact environment that is similar to heel strike running as compared with forefoot running. Forefoot running is a foot strike pattern that is most often used by professional distance runners like Galen Rupp, Molly Huddle, Tarnish Dababa, and Paula Radcliffe, just to name a few. Forefoot running is probably their favorite thing to do to run fast and, of course, to avoid injury because there is less impact force variables attached to forefoot running than in heel strike running and possibly in midfoot strike running as well. Because remember, midfoot strike running may actually produce very similar forms of impact variables as in heel strike running. Now, in contrast, forefoot strike running is less abusive on the body, and there's a lot of evidence in alignment with this. Forefoot running is associated with reduced impact shock levels, which is especially very handy if you are running long distances like the marathon. You always want to shield your body from high impact, and forefoot running is one of the best ways to really help you do that. This is how forefoot running will pay off in a big way, but we hear a lot of talk about midfoot strike running and how running with a midfoot strike landing style or landing pattern may help runners create a safer landing environment during running in comparison to a heel strike landing pattern. But midfoot strike running may create the same problems in terms of injury because landing with a midfoot strike may create the same high impact climate, very similar to heel strike running, especially if you run with a midfoot strike in traditional running shoes, which are running shoes that have a built-up padded heel in which the elevated cushion heel could make you prone to landing heel first, or with the heel strike landing pattern when you run. And there's a lot of research that complements this in that traditional running shoes may be setting your foot on the trajectory to heel strike when you run. This is how traditional running shoes sets the stage for running with forceful mechanics and a high risk of injury. Nonetheless, in running, one of the highest goals to help prevent running-related injuries is you want to avoid landing heel first when you run. And also, you might want to avoid landing with a midfoot strike because in some cases, a midfoot strike landing pattern or a flat-footed landing pattern during running is a softer version of a heel strike landing pattern during running that may do you no favors in terms of avoiding injury because by impact force standards, a midfoot strike landing pattern during running, like a heel strike landing pattern, may make it hard to shake off a lot of impact shock implicated in runner's knee and shin splints. For instance, a 2003 study in the Journal of Sports and Science, which I'll link below, found that midfoot strike running shared very similar impact force characteristics to heel strike running by many accounts on the element that the midfoot strike runners actually showed greater ankle dorsiflexion at touchdown, which caused the heel to kiss the ground first. What this means is that the midfoot runners weren't really midfoot striking when they ran. Rather, the midfoot runners were landing with a minor heel strike and generating the impact force variables produced in a heel strike landing pattern. Now, ankle dorsiflexion at touchdown during running is what heel strike runners typically do before they strike the ground on their heel. Heel strike runners pull up the front part of their foot in order to land on the heel first. This is ankle dorsiflexion at touchdown during running, which makes it easier to heel strike because remember, the forefoot is lifted back in ankle dorsiflexion at touchdown during running, which essentially exposes the heel to the ground, making it very easy to heel strike first, and therefore generates a large initial impact peak within the vertical ground reaction force. This force appears to be the base problem that makes lower leg injuries to thrive in running. Not only that, it is difficult to ensure that all aspects of your underfoot strikes the ground at the same time during running. When you try midfoot striking during running, chances are, depending very strongly on your footwear, your forefoot and your heel does not contact the ground at the exact same precise time, but rather, in many cases, and as supported in this study that I just mentioned, a midfoot strike landing pattern during running may generate high impact because the heel so often clips the ground first before the rest of the foot. Thus, more impact shock may be smuggling in a midfoot strike landing, like in a heel strike landing. From this, the fundamental question becomes, is a midfoot strike landing pattern really a midfoot strike landing when you run? Now, in most cases, should midfoot running be in a runner's best interest to use as a means to reduce the risk of getting injured while running? The answer is you may be better off landing on the front part of your foot first via a forefoot strike landing pattern when you run, because forefoot strike running has been defined as a less distressing style of running, and you may want to try forefoot running in more barefoot inspired / minimalistic running shoes rather than forefoot running in the traditional running shoe. The biggest takeaway here is that with midfoot strike running, you may think you are landing completely flat-footed in a midfoot strike landing style during running, but chances are you are actually clipping the ground heel first, which can be made worse in traditional running shoes because you essentially get less powerful sense of foot strike awareness. Thus, you could be heel striking without even knowing it and feeling it. Since the underfoot compressible material makes it very comfortable to heel strike during running, but it doesn't reduce the impact force variables of heel strike running. It just makes the heel strike impact force feel comfortable. Overall, the evidence implies landing with a midfoot strike running style may not let you achieve your injury prevention objectives. The research hints that some mechanical aspects of midfoot strike running may be very similar to heel strike running, and that since impact force variables may be very similar in midfoot and heel strike running, may set the stage for injury. Not only that, like I said, if you wear a traditional running shoe while you run, while trying to make the conscious effort to land midfooted or flat-footed, the key issue here is that in these shoes, you may fall into the trap of heel striking when you run if you don't pay close attention to how you land. Wearing thickly cushion-heeled running shoes withers away ground feel. Therefore, it's a little challenging to feel exactly where you are stepping on your foot when you run in cushion-heeled running shoes or the traditional running shoe. Indeed, lack of ground feel is a huge obstacle, especially if you've been a long-time heel strike runner and you are learning to avoid heel strike during running by trying to adopt a midfoot strike landing pattern. But now we are finding that landing midfooted when you run may come with some disadvantages. In some cases, midfoot strike running and heel strike running may again share very similar mechanics that produce potent forms of impact. And so you may be faced with injuries if you run with a midfoot strike landing, especially if you do so in traditional running shoes. To help avoid a lot of difficulties during running, aim for a forefoot strike landing pattern to ensure you land far away from the heel as possible at touchdown. Your heel strike potential is more diminished at touchdown in forefoot running than it would be in midfoot running. When you run, move your initial foot strike position to land on the front part of your foot first, which is your forefoot or the balls of your foot just ahead of the arch, and to do so in minimalistic barefoot feeling running shoes to keep your forefoot strike pattern very consistent to ensure your forefoot strike landing pattern doesn't fly off in different directions and mistakenly heel strike. For beginners, Minimalist running shoes is a very positive force that makes your forefoot strike landing pattern more navigable because it gets your perceptual awareness more consciously directly involved so that you clearly know where you are stepping on your forefoot, not on your heel first when you run. Why would you want to disrupt this form of communication between the feet and the brain with cushion-heeled running shoes and increase your chances of running with a heel strike that emboldens high-impact shock? The best real option to help avoid running injuries is to eliminate the determinants that cause running-related injuries. Heel strike running is now becoming more famously known for causing most running-related injuries. So you not only want to avoid heel striking during running, but you may also want to avoid midfoot striking during running as well, because inspired by the current findings, midfoot strike running may produce the same high impact outcomes as heel strike running, as midfoot strike running bears some mechanical similarities to heel strike running. For more straight line direction to safer running, make forefoot running your core interest, because your lower leg engages less intensively, less harmfully with the ground. You get less intensive levels of peak impact forces. Essentially, forefoot running has a leveling effect that puts you in a better position with the ground, helping to restabilize your biomechanics in a way that tamps down on high braking or deacceleration forces and other bone cracking forces that is so often measured and observable in heel strike running. To build a more viable forefoot strike landing pattern during running, minimalist running shoes are a good anchor at helping you develop and maintain a very accurate and organized and consistent forefoot strike landing pattern during running that's of low impact. So you really want to ally yourself with either running barefoot or running in minimalistic like running shoes that feel barefoot, because feeling the ground really helps you moderate your foot strike behavior. There's less distracting sensory information. Thinner running shoes are a better revealing indicator of your forefoot strike landing pattern. For more information on forefoot running versus heel strike running, please visit my blog, runforefoot.com, and subscribe to my YouTube channel to stay updated on all the latest research regarding the health benefits of barefoot running and minimalist running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads. Bye for now.